Blackstone Publishing presents Cormorant Lake, a novel by Faith Merino. This book is read by Lisa Flanagan. For Travis, Jack, and Edwin. The leaving. It was because of the bathtub that she left with the two little girls in the night. Dresser drawers pulled out and moved whole into the car. T-shirts and jackets stuffed into trash bags with Barbie dolls and blankies and binkies. Everything hefted out to her idling sangria red 92 Toyota Corolla. She'd already stocked the back seat with raisins, graham crackers, and two boxes of Lucky Charms because they were Lila's favorite. And the toddler had a big and constant hunger, even though she was all tender bones. Evelyn was good at moving silently, and she had to get the girls out of the house without waking anyone because she'd drawn a line at finding the baby in the bathtub, twisting like an alligator underwater. First, she got Lila, whose lean little goat legs dangled as Evelyn carried her through the house that smelled like ashes, lighter fluid, and sulfur. A cutting chemical sharpness, underneath a fungal human smell. Yeasty. She laid Lila down in the back seat, folding the three-year-old's legs and tucking the blanket around them before she went back for Mora. She lifted the baby, a little over a year old, maybe more, out of the torn playpen, carefully wrapping her in blankets to keep her asleep on the way out. Her hair was still wet, and Evelyn smelled it deeply as she laid her down next to Lila. Mora's eyes only briefly fluttered before she rolled onto her side, pressed her face into the back of the seat, and shuddered out a long sigh. Evelyn got in the car and drove away from the house. She drove slowly, cautiously, using her turn signals, keeping below the speed limit as she merged onto the 91. She planned to be out of California by the time the girl's mother woke up. Evelyn. A November sun came up over the eastern mountains as Evelyn drove north on the 5 through California's Central Valley. Thousands of acres of almond orchards and orange groves spinning off into the foothills. Morning fog creeping out from the mountains. Her defroster was broken, and she had to turn on the fan to clear the clouding windows. When her eyes got heavy and sleep came creeping in like water rising in a basement, she rolled her window down and let cold air blast her face until her eyes leaked. Just like Doris Clearwater's leaky eyes. Always damp for some reason. Doris Clearwater. Drying her eyes with her sleeve as she said, "This is Erin. She's going to crash for a while." And there was Erin. Wide forehead. Eyes too big for her face. Slender nose almost disappearing between her broad cheekbones. A toddler holding her hand and in the crook of one elbow, the tiniest pink baby Evelyn had ever seen. Lila and Mora. The girls woke sometime after sunrise with yawns and slow blinks. Lila sat up, and her eyelashes blazed gold as they drove through an almond orchard, sun flashing between the trees.
"I got to potty," she said.
Evelyn pulled the car onto the side of the road and got Lila out. Put her little pink flip-flops on her feet before setting her on the ground. She held the skinny girl by the armpits so she could squat and pee in the dirt, chips of brown glass glittering around them. The wind whipped their hair and the t-shirt Lila wore as a nightgown snapped as Evelyn tried to hold it out of the pee stream. By the time Lila was done, she was shivering, legs shaking as she balanced on her toes. Evelyn lifted her back into the car and got back on the freeway. She was slow and careful, so the trip took a full day. They passed reeking dairy farms where manure had been bulldozed into tarped mountains, the plastic weighted down with old tires. The chemical stink followed them for miles. Even when they'd gotten upwind of it, it had been years since she'd driven this stretch of the 5. And everything looked the same. It felt like she'd been in this exact moment before, even though she hadn't gone home since she left. They drove past rice paddies and strawberries.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.